Hi, hello and welcome to the channel Fix Your Mercedes. At the beginning, I would like to use this occasion to thank myself to some people that became members of the channel. At first, I would like to give one huge gratitude to special persons. One of them is Lockery. He is my first member, one of the oldest ones on the channel. My dear, please. Thank you for everything. Thank you for being a true member and supporter of the channel throughout the whole year. Thank you, my dear. Then, in order not to forget the oldest ones, the next one is Anthony Asmussen. Tak, my friend, thank you for being the member of the channel. Then, Tony Live TV is the second one. My man, thank you for supporting the channel. You're almost there. You're almost there. I'm just watching you and following your channel. Just following you. You're this close to start your car online. I'm hoping to see that as soon as possible. The next one in the row is Alexander Shashich. Hvala ti, druže, što si postao član kanala. Već sam ti se zahvalio na tome. And then the newest members of the channel. One of them is from Turkey, Refik Kaplan. Then Kim Holming, wherever you are, no matter, you're welcome to the channel, no matter from where you are. I really appreciate your deed. And a man from Poland, Tomasz Dirbus, right? If I spelled it correctly. And if you, yeah, you, want to be the first one to watch my video as it is fully uploaded, then hit the button join. Thanks. Well, what is the difference between being a member of the channel and a subscriber? Well, being a member of the channel, for this you will have to pay $2. $2 only. For these $2, apart from that, you have my huge gratitude, you will be one of the first people that are going to see an upcoming video in English. So, neither in Serbian, Spanish, but in English only. Because for my members, as I can see, the only one who speaks Serbian here is Alexander. And that's why I don't believe that there is anyone of you that speaks Spanish. And that's why, as I already said, the only videos in English you will be the first of those to see, to be able to see these videos. And sorry, above your name, the Mercedes logo will appear in order to make a difference between the members, between you that I have already mentioned, and all those who are either subscribers or not on my channel. Thank you. Well, this is actually not the thing I wanted to say in this video, and the thing I wanted to say now, I wanted to give you a sneak peek in my upcoming quadrilingual video, as I called it, as I was speaking about that video that is going to be quadrilingual. It's going to be in four languages: in Serbian, in English, in German, and in Spanish. In that video, I'm going to explain everything I know about KE, about Ke-Jetronic. So now I want to give you a sneak peek between the five systems, as there were Ke-Jetronic systems, and I want to give you just a difference between KE3A and KE3B. There was KE1, KE2, KE3A and 3B, and someone calls those systems KE3.2 and 3.5 and KE5.
Here, this is the older system on my car. Here you can see the ECU connector, and here is the one from the later version. Do you see the difference? Let me explain. On my system, the empty pins are 4, 14, 15, 19. We have manual gearbox and no AC. And on the later version, the empty pins are 4, 11, 14, 19. So again, as for this version, we have manual gearbox and no AC. Let's say it identical. The difference is that the newer version of the system, starting from September 89, has no contact for the air intake temperature sensor. On my car, this sensor sends signal both to the ignition module and to the ECU. On the newer versions, the sensor sends signal to the ignition module only. On the other hand, on the newer version, pin 15 on the ECU is not empty. On this contact, the ECU communicates to the OVP over its contact 30A, the ECU is always on, and if any code appears, the ECU stores it and sends it to the X11/4. Both systems are completely compatible to each other. I have the ECU from the newer version, and the only difference is that the ECU holds high revs for 28 seconds, approximately 1200, when the engine is totally cold.
But now, the moment I start the car, the RPM fall down to 750, between 750 and 800. There. Did you see that? Here. And the car is totally cold. So no more high RPM and then lowering it. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.